Science Academy, the science provider of the nation.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. So I have said the importance of numbers in the last couple of videos. So we were thinking about how the numbers can be used in various fields, right? Without numbers, it's very difficult for us to understand anything, right? I would say anything is impossible without numbers. So I mean, what I mean is, you know, the development which the world has moved on today is impossible without numbers. There are two powerful tools in mathematics, you know, not only in mathematics, in each and every field, right? The most powerful tools are being numbers, and the other one is the geometry. So here we are thinking about the numbers, and today I was planning to do about rational numbers, right? So in the last video, what we have done is a kind of a flowchart of how numbers are going to work. So in that flowchart, we came across something called rational numbers. So what are these rational numbers? We were also defined a rational number. Suppose if you have a number in the form of a over b, right? A over b, if you can write a number in terms of a over b, where a and b both are in integers, right? So now this curl the integers is a very new word for you guys, right? So what are these integers actually mean, right? So there are negative integers and positive integers, and you know, you have zero, and all together will make up integers. So if you consider the integers, so integers are all the numbers like this. Now if you have -5, -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, these kinds of numbers are called as integers, right? So apart from integers, you have a lot of numbers, meaning you have fractions, you have mixed numbers, you have decimal numbers. So likewise, you have a lot of numbers. Now, this particular number system is called as the integers, right? So this -5 is going up until minus infinity in that direction, and this plus numbers are going to go up until infinity in this direction. So this is what we call as an integer, right? So we call it as an integer. So we will say that it has to be integer, right? Furthermore, if you consider the positive integers, so these are called the positive integers, right? Positive integers. So we say curl is it, and we will put a positive mark on top of the curl is it. So it represents that positive integers. So what are the positive integers? Zero is not a positive integer, because zero is not a positive number. So from 1 to, you know, all the other numbers are going to be curl is a positive. So positive integers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and all these natural numbers. So we also say this positive integers as natural numbers, and the symbol for the natural numbers is going to be curl n. So integers and natural numbers. And furthermore, you have fractions. You have fractions, right? So if you have numbers like this, 3 over 2, 5 over 6, 3 over 2, any number like this is also comes under the rational numbers, because you see that, you know, these two people are integers, right? If you can write two terms, you know, I mean, you have to have a numerator and the denominator, whereas this both the numerator and the denominator should be an integer. If that was the case, then it is a rational number, right? Cool. So we have to think a little bit more about this, right? So we will do some problems, right? So we will do some problems. So let me ask you a question like this. Suppose if I have 5, and if I ask you guys, is this 5 a rational number, right? So what is the definition of a rational number? If you can write a number as fractional form, whereas the numerator and the denominator, both of them are integers, right? You should have a fraction in which the numerator is an integer and also the denominator also should be an integer, right? So if that was the case, then the number is called as a rational number. Now if you consider 5, can you write this 5 as a kind of a fraction? Number one question. So you would say that, yes, of course, right? How can you write that? Because you can say that 5 is equal to 5 over 1, right? So you have an integer here. So this is an integer. This is an integer. So the guy who is below is also an integer. So integer over integer. So this is simply a rational number. So this is a rational number. So the next one is, if you have a kind of a number, mixed fraction like this, 2.5, is this a rational number? Now just 2 into 2 is going to be 4, 4 plus 1 is going to be 5, 5 over 2. So this can be written as a fraction, whereas the numerator is an integer and the denominator is also an integer. In that case, 5 over 2 also should be a rational number. So this is also a rational number. So next question to you guys is, suppose if you have a decimal like this, 3.5214, right? So if you have a decimal like this, can you write this as a fraction or is this a rational number? If I ask you something like that, what would you say? So the number one thing that you have to understand is, you have to think is whether you can write this as a fraction. Right? So think about this, right? So if you think a little bit more on this, right, you will come to know that, you know, this can be written as a fraction. How so? You just write 3, right? 5, 2, 1, 4. You have moved 4 decimal places. So you can write 35,214. Since you have moved 4 decimal places, you have to write, you know, 10,000 underneath that. So what you have done now is exactly the same thing, which satisfies the rational number condition. You see that the numerator is an integer, denominator is also an integer. So in that case, this is a rational number, right? So our next problem comes when we think about numbers like this. For example, think a number like this, 10 over 3, right? 10 divided by 3. So 10 divided by 3. How many 3's are there for 10? Obviously, there are 3 10's, right? So, we will do the math here. 10 divided by 3 is going to be, there are 3 10's. 3 into 3 is going to be 9. 1 remains. You know, you can't divide 1 by 3. So, you put a decimal and you get 0 here. 10 divided by 3 is again 3. 3 into 3 is going to be 9. 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. So, you can't do anything else. You can't place another decimal. So, you automatically, you have to put a 0 here. 10 divided by 3 is going to be 3 here. 3 into 3 is again 9 here. You know, this will keep on continuing, right? So, you will have 3.33333. Infinite number of 3.33333 like that, right? So if you have infinite number of 333 like that, you'll have say 3, you know, you'll have right think about this, you'll have right infinite number of 3's and you know you have to divide that number by you know a number you have, you should have 1 0 0 0 0 up until infinity, you know. So infinity, what is this infinity actually means, we don't know, right? So what we think is, you know, if you have a number like this, 3.3333, and if you get 10 over 3, what our brain says is, right, remember this very carefully, but what our brain says is, this is a rational number, this is a rational number, and this is an irrational number. This is an irrational number. So that is what our brain says. But, you know, if you study mathematics in a very depth, right, and if you go to a lesson called real analysis, people study it in undergraduate levels, right? If you go to a lesson called real analysis, you have a proof of 3.33333 being a rational number. You have the proof, right? Even though 3.333 goes up until infinity, this 3 is going to continue up until infinity, right? So if you think about writing it as a kind of a fraction, right, you'll have to say that 3.33333 divided by 1000000 like that. You'll have to think about it in that fashion. But actually, you know, you have to have infinite number of 3's and infinite number of zeros. And all of a sudden, it gives us a question that what is this infinity actually means? Right? So what is this infinity actually means? So, you know, 10 over 3, you have an integer, so it's obviously rational. 3.3333, you cannot write it as a form of a fraction. That is what our brain says. But actually, 3.333 is equal to 10 over 3. It's equal to 10 over 3, right? So, you know, if you have a decimal place which is going up to infinity, right? And if you don't have a pattern, then it is called as an irrational number. But here, what you have is a pattern. 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, you have the pattern, right? You always have 3, you know. You can guess the next number. That is what you call as a pattern, right? So you have 3, what is the next number? 3, what is the next number? 3, so you have you have that pattern. So when you have the pattern, you know, you can guess what the number is going to appear next. So, you know, automatically we know that if you have a kind of a pattern, you call it as a recurring decimal. If you have a recurring decimal, then recurring decimals are always rational numbers, right? 3.333, you can't write as 3333 divided by 10000 up to infinity. You can't write that, but 3.3333 is 10 divided by 3. So you can write this as a fractional form. So you can't say this is an irrational number. So you will have to say that this is also a rational number. You will have to say that. Right? So anything, if you can write it as a fraction, you know, it is a rational number. For example, if you take a number like this, you know, let us say, 3.14231576812589, you know, a number like this, if you consider a number like this, can you guess the next number? You can't guess the next number. Why so? Because you don't have a pattern, right? So let's say it's going up to infinity. You know, you have some numbers involving the up until infinity. But you can't guess the other number. If you can't guess the next number, then this is called as an irrational number. This is called as an irrational number because you can't write this as a fraction. Right? But if you have something like this 3.1414141414, you know, like that. You know, you can guess the next numbers. And you know, for this number, there is a particular fraction. You don't know what is the fraction actually. You know, you don't know what is the fraction, but you have a fraction. That is the idea. You have a fraction. And these kinds of repeating decimal numbers, or you know, you have the same pattern, you have a kind of a repeating pattern. So these kinds of repeating pattern, right? And if it was a decimal, you call that decimal as a recurring decimal. Remember, recurring decimals are always rational. Always rational, right? So this is the ultimate point that you should know. So these kinds of numbers are irrational. These kinds of numbers are rational. So actually my question to you guys is, do you find numbers like this? Yes, you find numbers like that. So what are the examples? So what are the examples for such numbers? Number one example is pi, right? Number one example that I can provide you guys is pi, right? People say that pi is equal to 22/7, but this is just an approximation. You have to remember, this is just an approximation. This is not the accurate value, right? Pi is equal to 3.14, you know, even I don't know the next number, you know, but it has a kind of a number which is going up to infinity. The most profound point here is that this number doesn't have a pattern, right? Even if you consider root 2 is 1.41, something else like that. And it keeps on going without a pattern. When you have no pattern, then these kinds of numbers are called as irrational numbers, right? Basically, you know, strictly speaking, the numbers, root of prime numbers are you know, most of the times, as far as my knowledge, most of the times they are irrational numbers.